But most traits aren't like eye color, right?
Right. Most complex traits are actually a result of multiple genetic interactions with an environmental influence.
Well, going back to our nature and nurture phrase, how do we know how much of a trait is from nature or from nurture?
Well, it can be difficult to make a blanket statement about how much is nature and how much is nurture, because there can be a lot of variability from individual to individual. But what we can do is look at all the differences in a group of individuals and how much of that is caused by a genetic influence. This is what we call heritability.
Yeah, heritability. We talk a lot about that in psychology.
Sure. Heritability is measured on a scale from 0 to 1, where 0 means that variation in the trait is not due to genetics at all, whereas a 1 indicates that the variation in the trait can be explained completely by genetics. For example, when people talk about the heritability of a disease, they're referring to how much of differences in risk for that disease across the population is due to genetics.
Okay, so it's not the same thing as saying how much of a trait is genetic.
Exactly. Those are two different things, whether or not a trait is caused genetically versus whether the variability in a trait is due to genetics. Let's go and take a look at our example of height again.
Suppose we're measuring height in two different parts of the United States. Now, let's say in the first population, everyone has a very similar economic status and thus a very similar lifestyle. But in the second population, people vary a lot in their economic status and their resulting lifestyles. How would the heritability of height compare between population 1 and 2? Do you think it would be the same? Do you think it would be higher in population 1? Or do you think it would be higher in population 2? Remember, heritability is measured on a scale from 0 to 1.